Hi guys, so this video is very unplanned, wasn't expecting to film it, but I recently just posted a video, like a bikini haul, and I want to come on here and just say what has been in my head for a very long time now, and I haven't had the guts to actually speak up and talk about it, but I have finally. Just this video and the comments I've been getting have really angered me, and I want to finally open up and talk about something that happened to me in December that has changed my life forever. And I know it's happened to a lot of other people as well, and I just want everybody to know that they're not alone, and it's a fucking cruel world. It really is a fucking cruel world. So I'm filming this on my phone. I'm probably going to go really red because I go really red when I talk about things that genuinely are really important to me. So I'm going really red right now, but we're just going to ignore that. So yeah, this is just going to be a raw video that's not going to be edited. So in December, I'm not going to say everything that happened. I'm just going to say the details, just really short little snippets. So I got really drunk with one of my friends and two guys came round, and anyway, so I got really drunk and two guys came round. I can't really remember much because I was really, 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 really drunk. I couldn't even stand up. I couldn't see. I was just freaking passed out, mate. So they came round and we were all sat on a bed and we were just talking on whatever. And then, I don't really know how it happened, but one of them went with one of my ex-friends into her bathroom, and it was just me and this guy alone. Anyway, I don't really know if I want to say it, to be honest, but you can kind of see where it's going. So we had sex, and I don't really remember how it happened. I don't really know how it happened, but all I remember is just lying on the bed, having sex with a guy, and do not remember saying I wanted to do it. I don't remember him asking me. I don't really remember a lot of the details, to be honest, but I just remember that happened, and I remember trying really hard to get out. And because my friend was in the same position as me, and she really didn't want to do it with a guy either, so I was trying to get myself off him and trying to get out of her door and try and help her, and I kept getting pushed down and the door was shut in front of me, and I just remember feeling absolutely helpless and like I could not get out and I couldn't get out of his grasp, and he just kept pushing me down, and I was like trying to fight him off. I was trying to go get my friend and make sure that she was alright and try and stop the same thing happening to her. But I just kept getting pushed down, and I just hate it so much. And he had a knife, he had a machete, and I fucking couldn't remember it. I could not remember anything until my friend was telling me, yeah, you remember, like, he had a fucking knife. And then I remembered, and yeah, so that happened to me in December, and it has affected me so much, and I hate it. I hate how something so stupid, it's not even stupid, it's just how something can just like that, just. But yeah, anyway, so I went to the police about it and we got questioned. Well, we had to tell everything that happened, and I stupidly forgot about the knife. I didn't remember it until she said, and then I remembered. Anyway, I don't even know his name. I didn't know what he looked like. I didn't know anything about this boy. I had no idea who he was. And yeah, and the next thing I know, I was in the police station talking about it, saying like, you know, what happened. I had to throw out the room, I had to do tests, I had stuff shoved in my mouth, I had to wee in a cup, you know, I had to do pregnancy tests to make sure I wasn't fucking pregnant, because I could not remember if you used a condom or if you finished inside me. And I had to give statements. I said I didn't want to do a statement because I didn't want to go through the whole court thing. And at this point, nobody knew except my sister, and we went together. And I couldn't even tell my dad, because I just could not face telling him I had been raped. Anyway, so yeah, I was at the police station doing all this stuff, and then I had to come home and tell my dad. And I think that's probably the worst thing you could ever say to your father, that you have been raped, 16 years old. And yeah, so that happened, and ever since then I have been struggling with it. I didn't really want to talk about it, because it's not something you want to talk about, because I feel like when I talk about it I feel really weak, and all the memories come flooding back, and I just feel like that helpless girl that could not get out of his grasp, and I just hate it. Anyway, so a few weeks ago I got a message saying that they found the guy who sexually assaulted me, and they questioned him, and he didn't say anything, he didn't answer any of the questions, he just sat there supposedly not saying anything or answering anything. And the case has been closed, and they've not done anything about it, they're not going to take any more further action. And yeah, that just really, really pisses me off, because how can somebody get away with something like that? They don't care about how they've affected you in your life for the rest of your life. Mate, I'm never going to be that same girl I was before. They don't give a shit. All they care about is people who steal, who do drugs. They don't care about fucking things that affect you mentally, and I don't even know. So yeah, so that happened, and then they found out his name, and that's when it all got really real, like really real, being like, oh my god, this guy's a fucking real person. And yeah, so that is my story. And yeah, a lot of you probably didn't know that happened, and I didn't really want to share it, but the reason why I'm sharing it is because recently posted a bikini haul, well, swimwear haul, and I have gotten loads of really inappropriate comments on there from really old men, and stuff like that makes me feel so small and just so helpless and small, and I just hate it, because I just get pushed back to how I felt in December, and I just want to tell everybody that, you know, these fucking guys, mate, leaving comments being like, oh, you're so beautiful, like, you look so good, I'm in a bikini. I had this one really inappropriate comment where he, like, put, like, hashtags of, like, thongs, like, camel toe, stuff like that. And I was like, what the fucking fuck? How can people genuinely leave a comment like that on a 16-year-old YouTube post? Like, that is pervy, it's inappropriate, like, you know, what the fuck? Like, what the fuck? Anyway, can't delete this video because it's a brand deal. Can't delete it for at least 7 days. So I've turned the comments off. But not only that, they haven't just gone and left comments on that recent post. They've gone all the way to 3 years ago when I was 13 and left comments on my post. A sheen summer haul. Like, come on. So inappropriate, and I just want to talk about it and actually speak up about it and say, girls, you're not alone. You know, if you have fucking disgusting pervy men comment shit like this on your YouTube posts, Instagram, TikTok, whatever the fuck it is, you're not alone. And just want us to know that we can stand up for ourselves and say, you know what, this isn't fucking right, and I don't want people to feel like they're really small and helpless, like how I've been feeling the past few hours. Well, fucking hell, the past few months, not the past few hours. And yeah, I just, to be honest, I just wish that fucking disgusting men like that could actually be shown that this isn't right, this isn't how you're supposed to fucking talk to people. And I just wish that the police would do more about situations like what happened to me and actually show people that you cannot act like this, you cannot do stuff like this to women, to girls, to anybody, to men, to boys, to anybody. I wish they would actually, like, you know, show everybody that this is not right. And yeah, I just wanted to talk about that, and I just wanted to say how I hate that somebody can just ruin your life. You know, I'm so young, I've got my whole life ahead of me, and this stupid boy has ruined my whole life. I never want to have a boyfriend, I never want to talk to another boy, I never want to speak to one, I don't want to look at one. They physically repulse me over something somebody did to me. And I know not all guys are the same, but how do you fucking know that? You don't know that. You don't know that. You never truly know a person. And that is so scary. And I just hate that he's ruined my whole life for me. And I know that you're supposed to, like, rise above it and forget about it, but I can't fucking do that. You know? Like, I had, like, a couple of therapy sessions about it, and as soon as I spoke up about it and actually talked about what happened, I just felt myself spiraling down and down and down, because I was remembering everything. And I feel like if I just stop thinking about it and don't think about it, you know, I don't get upset about it, but these comments just bring back memories. And I just fucking hate feeling helpless and like I cannot escape. And that's why I've been going to the gym, you know, that's why I've been doing all these challenges and stuff to try and build myself up to get strength. That's why I box, I weightlift. You know, I'm constantly getting stronger because I never want to be put in a position again where I feel like I did in that night in December. I want to be strong. I want to be able to push people off me, you know. I want to be able to walk down the street and not feel scared for my life. And I don't know how long it's going to take for me to be comfortable to talk to a boy again, to be in a boy's presence. And, you know, I want to have a fucking wonderful life. I want to have a wonderful marriage. I want to get married. I want to have kids. I want to do all this amazing stuff. I want to find a soulmate. But I just can't because of this fucking guy. It's amazing how much something actually affects you. And it just is like, the days are going on and on, and they're getting worse and worse and worse. And as soon as I think about it, soon as something triggers me like these comments, that's it. And yeah, so yeah, I just wanted to say that, girls, you know, boys, whoever, you're not alone. I have gone through one of the worst things that could ever happen to you. I'm still here, I'm still going. And yeah, so to all the guys that are leaving comments on my YouTube posts, probably not going to watch this, but just want you to know how fucking vile, pervy it is, and absolutely disgusting. And the fact that you think you can just comment weird shit like this is so wrong. So wrong and so disgusting. And I just wanted to speak up about it because this is my channel, this is my safe space, this is where I want, you know, I want to bring positivity, I want to share, like, nice things, I want to share nice videos of me trying on beautiful clothes that I love, and I don't want to feel scared and anxious and trapped, like, people are going to leave weird comments. I want this to be a safe space, you know, I want to share vlogs of me and my friends having a fun time. I don't want to feel worried that people are going to judge me. And yeah, so moving forward, I'm gonna remove all comments like this, put a filter on all my videos. And, you know, if I want to do a fucking bikini haul, I'm gonna do a fucking bikini haul, and I'm not gonna worry about weird men commenting stuff, because I'm just gonna turn my comments off. I'm gonna block them. And that is what everybody should do, because just know that, you know, I don't even know, but that's my story. That is just something I've been wanting to talk about, but never really had the guts to, and this has just been my calling. And, you know, it's fucking, I think it's like 11:30 at night, and I just decided I wanted to make this video. I've got new makeup on, my hair is greasy as shit. Really need to wash it. And yeah, so thanks for taking the time to watch this video. You are not alone. And yeah, sending you all love. We'll see you next time. Bye.